Welcome student, I am Sanjukta Rani Das. I am faculty of Ganesh Coaching of Education. Previous class, I discussed about the what is computer and the binary and decimal. Today, I discuss about the data flow diagram. Data flow diagram means how we input the data into the machine, then output, then calculate the our program. So, data flow diagram. Data flow diagram. Input part, output, secondary storage unit, primary storage unit, arithmetical and logical unit, secondary central processing unit. First, input unit. Previous class about I discuss about the input unit. Input means we input the data through the computer. We input the data keyboard and floppy disk. First we input. When we input the data, at that time it go to the first step, primary storage unit. Primary storage unit means kono? The primary storage unit, the data is not valuable. We store the data in temporary. It is divided two parts, RAM, ROM and RAM. ROM means read only memory. RAM means random access memory. Here the data storage few minutes, then it go to the second step, secondary storage unit. Secondary storage unit means here the data storage permanently. Here the two step, PROM and EPROM. PROM means programmable read only memory. EPROM means erasable, programmable, read only memory. Here the data stores permanently. Whenever we want to see the data in future, at that time we can see at the secondary storage unit. Then go to the central processing unit. Central processing unit means CPU. CPU divided two parts. CPU means control unit. LU means arithmetical and logical unit. Whenever we want to see, learn about the arithmetical and logical unit, at that time we put the ALU. Central processing unit means it is a brain of computer. Without the central processing unit, the computer cannot do any things. So it is a central processing unit or brain of computer. Then we go to the output unit. Output unit means kono? In output unit we see the our calculation, our program, etc. So it is a output unit. Output unit example, desktop. Desktop means, what is the meaning of desktop? Desktop means disk operating system. The desktop holds some icon and task bar. Icon means it is a key to open any program. Icon two types, general icon and default icon. General icon means kono? The icon which we create. Default icon means the father of computer, Charles Babbage. When the Charles Babbage discovered the computer, at that time he put the five icons. That is called default icon. Default means kono? Aditya. The default icon first, my computer, my document, Internet Explorer, my data places, recycle bin. Then we go to the desktop. Desktop means the full screen display on your monitor when booting is started. What is the meaning of booting? Booting means loading the operating system into main memory. Desktop means loading the operating system into main memory. What is the meaning of main memory? The CPU. When we type anything inside the keyboard, then it go to the first primary storage unit, then it go to the secondary storage unit, then go to the CPU, central processing unit. Why it is a brain of computer? It is decided what is wrong and what is right. So it go to the main memory, loading the operating system into main memory is called booting. The desktop holds some icon and taskbar. Icon two types, default and general icon. Default icon, my computer, my document, my data places, internet explorer, recycle bin. Then we go to the, what is the meaning of taskbar? Taskbar means taskbar means it is a button of the desktop. It holds the start button and notification area. How we open the start button? We previous class we discussed about the mouse. Mouse means it is a graphical user interface. So start button means how we open the start button. How we open the start button? How we open the start button? First step, we press the mouse, then click inside the start button. Second step, click inside the window key. Third step, select, then press the enter. What is the meaning of enter? It is execute command. Then we go to the learn about. What is the meaning of notification area? Notification area, through notification area we can see the system date and time. Through notification area, we can see the system date and time. Then we learn about the recycle bin. Recycle bins kono? It is a just like a dustbin. Here all the deleted items are stored. So it is a recycle bin. Recycle bin. Recycle bins means it is a just like a dustbin. Here all the deleted items are stored. Delete two types. Permanent delete. Permanent delete, temporary delete. Permanent delete means here the deleted items are not stored inside the recycle bin. But temporary delete means here the store the data not delete the data permanently. Whenever we see the document, then it can be possible because all the data store inside the recycle bin. So we can call the recycle bin, it is a just like a dustbin. Permanent delete, it cannot be possible return to the data from the recycle bin. Then we discuss about the folder and file. Folder means kon? It is a just like a shelf. File means it is a collection of some information. In folder we cannot write about. Here in folder we can store the some folders and subfolders and files, but in file we can write any things. So it is a collection of some information. How we create the folder? How we create the folder? First we press the right click, then new, then folder. That type we press the right click, then create the text document or otherwise we call it files. It has no extension, but it has two name. Suppose we write Rita dot txt. It is a primary name. It is a extension name. Extension name. So file has two names, the primary name and extension name. Next class, we discuss about the computer. Thank you.